I hope you enjoyed that start to finish process. This sled that I started with was a sled that I found at like a vintage Christmas craft bazaar show. And I just loved how, you know, the wood was very old looking, distressed, sort of already painted red, perfect size to do a little decoration on. It's actually, let's see, just the sled size alone, just to give you a little bit of a measurement here. Just the sled itself is only 10 inches in length that way, and then straight across is just about 6 inches that way. So it's a nice little small area to kind of do, you know, a design on for Christmas, and I wanted it to tie in with a lot of the wreaths I had been doing this year for my craft bazaar sale, but I had kept a couple for myself, and I wanted it to match those wreaths and things that I had kept for myself. So I started, you saw me laying down some greenery. It was greenery I had got at Hobby Lobby. I cut several different pieces off and I laid those down. And I guess let me backtrack. The first thing you saw me do was take some greenery. I think that was the first thing, or somewhere along this order. And then I used this Santa snow, this can of Santa snow that I had gotten from Walmart. $1.50 a can. And it just kind of gives it that real kind of nice, you know, little bit of a wintry look. So I had sprayed that, and I'd sprayed some berries and stuff like that. And then, let's see, oh, I believe you saw me go in on some of these other little berry picks, and I had sprayed them with Elmer's, just a spray adhesive. And then I dipped them in, you know, my salt and glitter mixture just to kind of make them look a little bit kind of sugared. I like that. I did the same process to the bells. You saw me do that. Let's see, what else did I do? Oh, I spray snowed some pine cones. And then, oh, and one quick other thing I did at the beginning is I took some regular bells and I painted them with this, it's called rusty paint, to make them look really kind of rusty looking. Can you see that? I love this. There's lots of processes out there, crafting wise, where you can take things and make them look rusty. But I find this is like the way easiest, and I love it. My cousin had sent it to me. It's by Viva, and it's called Rusty Paper. And actually, when you open it, it looks a lot more red in color. Okay, it looks a lot more red in color. So, but when it dries, because I was kind of a little bit scared at first, you can almost see it on the bottom, it's more kind of a reddish tint to it. But when it dries this real pretty like brownish color. Can you see that difference of the bottom of the lid to the actual color on the bells? It dries a nice dark brown, and it dries rusty. It's got some texture in the paint. I think it's a little sand in there. If you wanted more texture, you could add sand to the mixture to make it more lumpy bumpy. But you know what? I paint it with this, heat set it with my heat tool. It comes out looking rusty, lumpy bumpy. Love it. Easiest, quickest product out there that gives me the look I'm looking for, and I don't have to do 5 different types of alcohol inks. I don't have to do, you know, all these other processes to it, which granted I love watching and seeing people do. I am just impatient. I want to paint and go, so that's what I did. So you saw those kind of processes at the beginning of the video. Now let's backtrack. Laid down some greenery. The first thing I cut up was this pick that I had, and I got it, and it all looked like these stems of these sugared berries, and I got this pick at Hobby Lobby, all my greenery from Hobby Lobby, and I got it to literally cut it apart and lay on my projects. So that's what I did. I cut it apart. You saw me fan it out, lay it on my projects. You also saw me, I laid it down in some hot glue, and then I got this at Dollar Tree, this Betty Crocker silicone spatula, so that when I lay it down, you saw me press into it with the silicone spatula, not burning my fingers, using a silicone spatula, and that silicone, of course, does not stick to the hot glue. So it's a great way. It's, I love this because it's got a nice skinny end. I rarely use the fat end, but I do have a nice skinny end to, you know, push things down into hot glue and not mess my fingers up. So I kind of laid those down in, and then I laid some other greenery on top, and I laid the cute little snow things that I had done on in there. This is some curlicue stuff I found at Walmart. They have a red and a silver, and I got the red. It's curlicue on one end, and then it has a great big long straight stem, but the whole thing is wired, so I make it go a little bit further, and I cut the pick right below the curlicue, cut it in half, and I take that long stem, and you saw me just wind it around like a little paint tube I had to make more curlicue to get some on the other side. So it just makes it go a little bit further if you're not wanting to use it like in a vase and you want really tall curlicues. So I put that in there, showed you how, I hope it was visible enough, how I just took those little bells that I sugared and I twisted them onto wire, and then in between each bell, I took that wire and wrapped it around a little, I just lost the name of it. Oh my gosh, wrapped it around one of these, just lost the name of it. That's so funny. Skewer, thank you. Thank you for somebody telling me that. You're probably yelling, skewer! A skewer, I wrapped it around, and then I'd add another bell, and I'd kind of twist the bell on, and I'd wrap wire around the stick in between, add another bell, twist it, etc., etc. So I put four or five bells on that wire and made some cute little curlicue sugared bells on wire and kind of stuck them out to give them more depth. Added the different picks inside. These are some more snowy picks. I kind of added those near the end, but still it's, you know, tucked in the process. These are little clear gems I got also from Hobby Lobby, you know, in the Christmas section. These are some old, these little tiny ones, some old berries I've had in my stash forever. I don't even know where I got them. That was the last little tiny bit. I do remember they came on like a big long roll of it, you know, but that was the last little bit of it. I layered, you saw me cut this. This is actual wire ribbon I got at Hobby Lobby. I love this stuff. It was on sale. It was half price. So it was $5 a roll. And I just cut off what I need. Love it. Love it. I like, that's all I have left. I've been using it on everything. And I don't make a full bow. You saw me just kind of wrap a little bit around each side, kind of squeeze it in the middle and shape it so that it gives me the facade of a full bow. But I love that texture and that look of that, you know, that chicken wire in there. It's just gorgeous. Just finishes it off for me. And then I started layering in the center, and I started laying different mulberry flowers, all from Renee's shop. The little white kind of ones are the mulberry. They're wild roses, gardenias, and leaf flower set. So I layered a few of those in there. And then the poinsettias also again came from Renee's shop, and it's the Christmas flower set, and I've got them in the winter white. She's got a few different colors of the poinsettias in there. Mine are the winter white, like I said. I layered in there, which kind of got covered up, but still very pretty. It's Reneabouquets three-layer lace flower applique. You get that in a couple of color choices, I believe a dusty rose and a white, and you can get it like two per set, and you can get them both white, you can get them both dusty rose, or you can get them, you know, one of each color. And let me see if I've got another one right down here in my next set of projects that I want to do. Let me grab that for you so you can see it a little bit better. Here we go, we get a little bit better look at it. This is the three-layer lace. Hope I said that, because there is a two-layer lace one, a little bit different design of it. But I love these. They're just so soft and pretty. So that's what I kind of layered right in there. And then I layered like a little frame on top. It's just a little $1.50 resin frame, $1.50 bin at Michael's. Also, you saw me kind of tuck in there are these beautiful Reneabouquets, beautiful board pieces. And these are from the quilling set. These are my favorite. You'll find I almost use them on everything. And it comes in this gigantic set of these different quilling pieces that come in the kit like this. And like the leaves, love them. And then of course those curlicues, there's different sizes of the sets, there's other shapes to the pattern, and then she's broken the sets up into different patterns as well, so you don't have to buy the whole big set if you're just looking for certain pieces of the sets. She's got that broken up. Anyway, so I love tucking them out. They just provide that little whimsical touch right in there. This one I actually went in off camera because the bow kind of covered up one of them that I went in with a smaller size and added another piece in there, so it looks a little bit bigger over here. Let's see. And then I tucked in these cute snowflakes. These are also Reneabouquets beautiful board. These are the vintage snowflakes. It's a set of seven, and I tucked one right in there in that flower applique. I've got one right over here, and then I've got another one again up here. I love these vintage snowflakes. There's vintage snowflake sets, there's shabby snowflake sets, there's the beautiful bits where they are the most teeniest, tiniest of snowflake sets. In case you missed my last video, I'll show you a few of them here. Here's some of the main snowflakes. These are the little teeny tiny beautiful board snowflakes. I mean, they just fit right on the pad of my finger. And even with as much how tiny they are, look at the intricate design. You can see right through them. They still have that quality of that intricate cut there. And I am just in love with the snowflakes. I mean, some of these, they're just my favorite. Gorgeous. Anyway, so those are the snowflakes, set of seven, like I said, the vintage snowflakes. And then right on top, this is one of the newer releases this month, you know, December. This is printed beautiful board die cuts. Renee has quite a few in her shop. My last project, I brought in this real beautiful printed die cut, and I'll be using one of those again on my next project. And she's got these in different colors. But this one is called the Christmas Holly die cut. Super cute, riding her little, you know, hobby horse there. It's got the little jingle bells around it. These do come in different sizes, and you can choose your size that Renee has available for you. The color on these printed beautiful boards is just exquisite. They are bright. They are beautiful. The design of them are just gorgeous. And Renee, you all need to know, all these designs of her printed beautiful board or her regular beautiful board, they are all Renee's designs, okay? She doesn't just go online and snag some clip art and reprint it. They are her designs, as in case with even like her butterflies. She paints them and reprints them into her computer. I don't know the whole process, and I know I'm getting it wrong. Forgive me, Renee, but she shoots them into her program and how she does it and reprints them back out and cuts them, and she makes the little antenna and she adds the antenna. And so the same with all these beautiful board pieces. These are her designs, and some are designs are inspired by those on the design team, but she takes them a little bit further and adds her spin to it and how she wants to do it, and they are one of a kind originals, okay? So you're not just getting clip art off the computer, and they are beautiful. You will not be disappointed. All the beautiful board is double-sided. The printed beautiful board is single-sided, but they usually do come in like a right or left facing, so there's some options for you, okay? Then down below that whole ensemble there, oh, I did put in, these are just some little filigrees from my stash I had painted white. And then I tucked in like a little bit, these are like little Dollar Tree picks I cut up because they look like little chunks of ice. So I kind of tucked those in here, here, and right up in here. Off camera, I added actual, like I bought this bundle of sticks at a craft show. So I added some, I broke that up and added some sticks into the set to give it more of a realistic feel. And then you come down below this whole ensemble here, and I added some beautiful lace. I made it into a bow. This is Reneabouquets lace is the first layer I added, and this is called Promise Ring Lace. Real beautiful. I left it as its original color and kind of made a bow. And then I came in with some ribbon from my stash, wire ribbon, and had beautiful kind of brown tones. I thought it went in well with the kind of the brown of the bells and the greenery a little bit. I made another little bow on that. This is a tag that I made in distress myself. I baked these in the oven. I printed the things off my computer. Long process, but they smell wonderfully like cinnamon. And it just says warm winter wishes on it. Added my bells there. This is just some twine I got at Hobby Lobby, and you saw me cut it into a few pieces. I laid down, you know, glued one bell, laid down those three pieces of twine in the center, and glued the other bell right up next to it, and everything's just kind of laying off here really pretty. And then I added in some pine cones. Some of these, I actually might be ones I got from Walmart. You can buy them in the miniature section, but I do have ones I've gotten from my yard, but I was running out of the sizes I needed, and these are like a dollar or something. And, you know, I sprayed them white as well, like I said at the beginning there, and, you know, kind of tuck those in. So that is the whole process, and I think it's just going to look really cute kind of sitting, you know, up like this. I've made it so it can sit up and it won't harm anything, or I can kind of slant it or just lay it flat, however I want to look at it. And I'll kind of show you everything from all angles. Okay. All right, so there is that project. I have all the links down below to everything Reneabouquets, as well as the link to the blog where you will see my work, of course, and other designers' work. There will be a link to my blog. You can see more close-up photos, so you can go to Renee's blog. You want more inspiration from other designers as well? You can go to my blog, see some projects, whatever you want. If you haven't already, please like this video. Please share it on social media if you'd like. Please subscribe to my channel. I love to have all of my subscribers along. I thank you for all my new subscribers that have been coming along. It is just unbelievable how you all are supporting me and loving my work. I thank you for sharing your time with me, and I'll talk with you again soon. Bye.